Yeah, I'm doing it. I software.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good evening. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Nice to see you again. Hope you're all nice and dry now. And if you're not, we have nice Christmas spirit music to warm you right up. You know, it's been Christmas in St. Ambrose since October, hearing all the wonderful melodiousness that's been coming from Mr. Chiaratola's classroom. And the students have worked very hard in the past months to bring you this nice concert that we look forward to every year. I know last year we were still able to bring Christmas cheer to you via your living room, and we are super excited that you were able to join us in person. I'm sure the students are going to be like, oh, I'm not going to miss the same old school, but I know you'll be supportive and make some money. I'd like to introduce you now to Mr. Chiaratola. He is our director. He trains the students from all day long in our music. And he's very proud to introduce our band to you, who's also working equally as hard. Mr. Chiaratola.
Thank you, Mrs. Andrea. Well, it's really great to be back in person. Our last concert, live concert, was 2019. Seems like a million years ago now, but it's really wonderful that we've persevered as a society, and here we are. So hopefully we can spread some joy to you this for the Christmas holiday, and you'll enjoy a lot of the diverse music that you'll hear. And the kids have really worked hard, so thank you for you know, your children and your support as parents of our school. I'd like to also thank, of course, the administration for their support and our teachers who buy into what we do, as well as our custodial staff that does a great job of making it festive and really, really nice looking. Okay, so without further ado, I'd like to get started. In addition to our vocal program, we have a very nice band program led by Janet Bender and her assistant, Chris Klaus. So we're going to start with a few band songs, and then you'll hear a lot of singing the rest of the evening. So I hope you enjoy. Most importantly, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you. to the program and we see the start of pre-K children, and we go by grade all the way up to eight. And that is a finale.
So while our little guys are setting up, I'd like to invite Father Jack to come forward. We do have two door prizes available. Courtesy of the ticket stubs, Father Jack.
I'll knock over somebody's computer.
Mix them up good. Gift cards.
Hey. There we go. Who we got? Who we got? Adina.
Oh, she wrote her name. Adina, 181. Mrs. Adina, you are the recipient of a $50 gift card. Your ticket number is 117. Congratulations. You can claim your prize at the end. This is 117. At the main entrance at the conclusion of our concert.
Are you serious?
It's a Catholic school. You want to have a blessing and a prayer?
Yes, Father.
In the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So come, Holy Spirit, help us tonight glorify God in our children's voices and all their talent and all their hard work. Bless everybody here. Have a beautiful Christmas. And I know I'll see you at Mass. In the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He may or he may not. Depends on that. They need to be able to see him. Yeah. For the little ones, he probably has to stand. For the older ones, he probably has to stand. That's a good
thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Reese's and Bella. It's the name.
They're like, oh, this is like, oh, Thank you. I was contemplating it.
Yeah.
She was like, oh my god, don't talk to me. Okay, but
I'm like, I can do this secret. I'm like, touch them more. They're both. Oh, no, yeah.
Do you see? That was the one that was like dancing and like using his little hands. When you were singing, you saw it?
Yeah.
So cute. Oh, I've never seen it.
As you can see, we've tried to do a mixture of traditional as well as some more modern songs so that the kids get the experience of different types of Christmas music. There's so much of it today. And I try not to forget the traditional because I think that's important too for their experience vocally. But some of the older groups do more modern songs. So you'll hear, you know, some songs that you hear with like rock bands behind them. You know, or at least instrumental groups that have guitars in them. So, and we'll start with this one. So here we go.
Across the make me happy with the joy.
Okay, for this we're adding some musicians. So we have the Savarese brothers, we have Jake on drums, and Jason on guitar, as part of the band.
Thank you.
blow Wham That was released in December 1984 on CBS Records. The song was written and produced by lead singer George Michael and has been covered by many artists since its original release.
Mr. Grinch, you really are a dear. You're as cuddly as a cactus, you're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. You're a toxin envy. Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39.5-foot pole. You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in.
Inside a snowflake, like the one in your sleeve, there happened a story you must see to believe. Way up in the mountains, in the high range of Pantoos, lay the small town of Whoville, the home of the Whos. Ask any Who, and they'll have this to say, there is no place like Whoville around Christmas Day. Every window was flocked, every lamppost was dressed, and the Whoville dancers pranced around in their Christmassy best.
Where are you, Christmas?
for their toys. And then they will make noise, noise, noise. And then the Who's young and old will stop for a feast, which is something Grinch cannot stand in the least. The Who pudding is done. Now time for the roast feast. This will be a delicious Christmas feast. Which is something the Grinch cannot stand in the least. And then they do something for like least of all. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, would stand close together with bells ringing, and they stand hand in hand singing. And the more the Grinch thought about this Christmassy thing, the Grinch said to Max, "We must stop this whole thing from coming, but how?" Then the Grinch got an idea, an awful idea, a wonderfully awful, awful idea. With this coat and hat, I'll look like St. Nick. Then he loaded up the sleigh with some old empty sacks, hitched up his new reindeer dog, Max. All the windows were dark, the cold filled the air, when he came to the first little house on the square.
"You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus, you're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel."
He slipped it in slunk with a smile most unpleasant, and then he took every last present. "Santa, why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why?" The Grinch was caught by this tiny Who daughter, who had got out of bed for a cold glass of water. "There's a light on the tree that won't land on one side, so I'm taking it back to my workshop to fix it, my dear, then I'll bring it right back here." His foot fooled the child. He patted her head. She got her water and went back to bed. Then the last thing he took was a log for the fire. And then he went up the chimney, that old liar. And the one thing he left in the house was a crumb much too small for even a mouse.
"I don't see him."
"Rats!" Then he did the same thing to the other Who houses, leaving crumbs much too small for other Who mouses. On the top of his mountain, the Grinch was happily humming. They are finding out now that Christmas is not coming. So then he paused, and the Grinch put his hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started out low, but the sound wasn't sad. Why, this sounded merry. It was merry, very. Every Who down in Hillville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all.
Oh, no.
It came without ribbons, it came without tags, it came without packages, boxes, or bags. And then the Grinch puzzled and puzzled till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas doesn't come from a store, maybe it means a little more. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville they say that the Grinch's small heart grew three sizes that day.
brought back the feast. And the Grinch himself carved the roast beast.
Parents, at this time, please take your seats.
Christmas tree, yeah. rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can't see, every couple tries to stop.
Let Us Know is a song that was recorded in July 1945. It was written in Hollywood, California during a heat wave as its songwriters imagined cooler conditions. Please enjoy our version as we hope for snow during this Christmas year.
Let us know.
We're almost there. Tell them we're almost there. Michael, we're almost there.
Two more.
Winter Wonderland is a winter song popularly regarded as a Christmas song. Written in 1934 by Felix Bernard and Richard B. Smith. Through the decades, it has been recorded by over 200 different artists. Some of the artists include Perry Como and Guy LaBarbera. Please enjoy our version of this famous song.
Walking in a winter wonderland. Walking in a winter wonderland. மீனும் பிஞ்சு வந்து கிடக்கிறது கிடைக்கு.
Yeah, there they go.
I'm not going to be the last person to go.
What do you mean? I don't feel free.
Where's my Grinch?
But the eighth are not here.
Fifth grade should now sit down. No, I. It's what I do. Like, this is now you're in my wheelhouse. If you're going to draw grand square on the paper, like, long, now you're in. The front row should be back.
Everybody sit.
Oh, yeah, she's like, I'm done with all you. Oh, there's the Blues Brothers back there. I
There. Oh my God.